Hi everyone, my name is Valerie and I am the Outreach Coordinator for Future Energy Systems. The book we're reading today is Green City, How One Community Survived a Tornado and Rebuilt for a Sustainable Future. And it's written and illustrated by Allan Drummond. I remember the night when a tornado destroyed Greensburg in 9 minutes flat. All of my things, our house, everything was blown thousands of feet into the air. When it was all over and we climbed out of our shelter in the basement, everyone's past had been swept away. Suddenly, the entire town of Greensburg had no future. How bad is it? Is everyone okay? It hit the whole town. My roof's gone. Upstairs? There is no upstairs. Use a cell phone as a flashlight. 11 people died because of the storm. It took 12 people to lift a truck off Mr. Schmidt's house. It was like a huge bomb had gone off. Our school was destroyed just 2 weeks before graduation. The hospital, 9 churches, the water tower, the drugstore with its soda fountain, the grocery store, the 2 hotels, the 3 banks, the theater, and everything else? Just gone. The trees were shredded to nothing, not a bird in sight. The only buildings left standing were the courthouse, the historic S.D. Rabinette building, and Greenberg's giant grain elevator complex. And looking at the town from high up, it was clear that nothing was left. Some people were asking, what good is Greensburg anymore? After all, we'd only been a little town in the middle of endless cornfields. Down on the ground, it was a gigantic mess to clean up. The very next day, we met in a huge emergency tent set up amid the rubble outside the courthouse. 500 people were there, along with TV news teams, emergency crews, and volunteers. With almost no buildings left, the only thing that remained of Greensburg was the people. So we're leaving the town just like that? What good would wooden houses be against the power of a tornado? Everybody out. No, let's move out, rebuild, and move back in. That's 1,400 people. That would be throwing money out the window. It seemed like the end of our town. But some people saw the whole situation as an opportunity for a fresh start. Soon the big question for everyone became, what do we want to be now? Let's not just build the same old thing we're always building. We're gonna make a brand new town, and we gotta do it right. Everyone set to work. The president flew in and declared Greensburg a disaster area. So many volunteers flocked to the town that we had to build a whole trailer park for them. Donations came from all over Kansas, the United States, and the world. The government sent experts to help us. And there was a whole lot of rubble to clear out. More than 388,000 tons. We had to move out of town and find somewhere to stay during the big cleanup. Goodbye, Greensburg. By the summer, we were living in our own small city of 300 trailer homes outside Greensburg. Life was not easy, and there were disagreements. Some people moved away and never came back. Out there, living close to the weather, we realized how hot Kansas really could be. Who took my fan? I'm boiling up in here. We had to drive everywhere. Turn back! You forgot the milk. And there was always the chance that our trailers would be blown away by the wind. We kept dreaming of what Greensburg and our new homes would look like. We did a lot of talking about how to build again. Sure, we all agreed on tornado-proof houses, and houses that we could keep cool in the summer and warm in the winter without using more fuel than necessary would be great. The word green kept coming up at every meeting. Isn't green just a color of paint? Asked Bob Dixon. Then Daniel Wallach spoke up. Green is basic common sense, he declared. Don't use up more than you need. It's sustainability, the Kansas farmer's way. Mr. Wallach opened an office and called it Greensburg Greentown. Not just green houses, a whole green city, he said. The whole idea of our green city had everyone excited, and some people got really creative. Lana and John Jansen reclaimed the kitchen cabinets and tiles from the remnants of their old house. We're recycling. Daniel Wallach suggested the silo eco-home with rounded walls like the grain elevator complex that survived the storm. Jill and Scott Ehler started working on an amazing wind-resistant geodesic dome home made from wood panels.
It looks like a soccer ball.
Bob Dixon designed a super strong, super insulated wood frame for his home. I want it green. 16 sustainable, affordable houses, called the Prairie Point Townhomes, would be built for Greensburgers right on Main Street. But these were difficult times, and not everyone had the money to keep going. It just doesn't add up for us. My family was lucky, and for the next 2 years we worked hard to build our home in as sustainable a way as possible. The town's businesses were rebuilding green too, new offices for startup companies and a retail center. The 5.4.7 Art Center arrived by truck and was put together by University of Kansas architecture students. On the outskirts of town, we built a wind farm big enough to power the whole community. The banks made sure their new buildings were as eco-friendly as possible. So did the Best Western Hotel, and beside it, the Kiowa County Memorial Hospital. Our new hurricane-proof water tower was constructed next to the new green Bigwell Museum. We knew our school had to be at the very center of it all. The plans looked exciting. For 3 years, we only had small trailers for classrooms, but we became experts in environmental science. Our new school was going to be one of the greenest in the United States. It took a few years for everything to come together, but now look! Greensburg is Green City! We moved into our new houses, and Greensburg has finally come back to life. I still remember the night when the tornado destroyed our town in 9 minutes flat. Back then, it really did seem like the end for Greensburg. Our town and our future were shattered. But we did rebuild into one of the greenest towns in America. That's official. The president even said so on TV. A global example of how clean energy can power an entire community. By thinking and building green, we've given Greensburg its future. We plan for the future because the future is green. Just ask the experts. Better means green, and green means common sense. And that was Green City. Isn't it amazing? An entire green community. What about your own community? Is it green? Can you come up with any ideas that could help green it more? Check out the activities below and join us next week for Storytime. Bye, guys! Thank you so much for watching Future Energy Systems video. Make sure to subscribe so you don't miss any of our exciting content. Check out the links below to our website and learning page where you can find activities, learning extension, and more. You can also sign up on the website for notifications for future videos and interactive opportunities. There's so much to learn as we explore our energy future.